We're going to look at a problem. It find if a given input stream containing all init characters. So if it has any duplicate character, then we just have to return a false. If it is unique, then return true. So the output would be a true or false. So how we can do is that we can use some additional data structure to keep track of the duplicate characters. The time complexity would be n because we are going to traverse one time, the linear time. So the time complexity would be n. So how we are planning to do is that, like if we want to do it with an array, 0 to 256, you can have that array as 256 characters. So because it's ASCII, we know that ASCII contains, like there are like 256 ASCII characters, right? So all the caps, capital letters, all the small letters, 1, 2, 10, and special characters, including all, it's like 256 characters. So we are taking it in that notion that 256 is the length of the array. And as we find that element, we're going to find what is the decimal value of h. So if it is 72, 72 is the decimal value of h, and then input into the input the value 72 here. And when we find this is h element, right? When we find e, the second element, then input into the 69th position, and then input l into the 76th position. So when you try to input the n, one more addition, the another l, so we know it, this is already filled up, right? So this will nowhere be zero. So the other all elements will be zero. So when you fill this up, it is nowhere zero. Then we can like very well say that it is a duplicate string, is input string is duplicate, and then just return false. So this is how we do it using array. We can also do it with the help of hash map. So how we are going to do hash map is that like input as you get the elements, input h and have a counter as 1, and input e, so counter as 1 and l 1. If you get the second L, so the counter would be not 1, right? So there is a count 1. So with this help, we can find out this is nowhere 0 or empty, right? It should be null, right? The value should be null. You will not get the key values of that. So or 0. So it will not be of this value. It is 1, right? So if it is containing 1, when you trying to input the second time, if the value is already 1 for that particular key, then straight away say that this is a duplicate string, like this string contains a duplicate character. So let's jump on to the code and have written a method like use is unique character taking input string. This is an exit condition, and I'm converting into an array. Character array, and this one the code I have implemented using an array implementation 256. So for int, like loop through the characters one by one. So here I'm saying that input of I, when you say you might be knowing whatever the characters, it is always in the int form. So the decimal values I of in of I, if you say this is a decimal value for h, it would be 72. So in 72, we are going to input into the 72 position. The value would be 72. We're going to input that way. And we would like what we are saying, if both are same, if this value in this input is already like, if the array is already containing the 72 value, then just return false, else add it into that position. So at the end, we're going to return true, else return false here. So this is very simple coding. Just have in mind that the like why you have to use, like when to use this array and when to use hash map. So in the advantage of using array is that we know it is a constant length, 256 characters. So if it is hash map, it is growable. And if the input string is only like 5 or 10, so we're going to use only those many length in hash map. But in array, this is always 256 characters, right? So that is one condition. And the second thing is that hash map is internally is using two arrays to map this key and value. So you can just discuss on that part and decide which one you want to choose. Thank you guys. It's hope it's easy to understand.